Hello people, in this video we want to look at what velamentous cord insertion means. Basically, it's a cord abnormality. So here, what are you looking at here guys? You're looking at the placenta. So this is your placenta and here you have the umbilical cord. So from the fetus, what are you getting? You're getting some blood vessels, right? These are the fetal blood vessels. Arteries and veins, both they have shown here. And here you can see the placenta. Basically, how should a normal insertion be? Of these, you can see here, they are well within the placenta, isn't it? But here, what is happening, the cord is attached to the membranes. What is the cord attached to? The cord is attached to the membranes. The branching vessels traverse between the membranes for a varying distance before they reach and supply the placenta. So they are not directly going to the placenta. They are attached to the membranes. They are entering, traversing between the membranes for a varying distance before reaching and supplying the placenta. Okay. So this is what is velamentous cord insertion. So basically people, there are many types of abnormalities of placenta. Okay. So here you can see there is a battledore placenta. There is a velamentous insertion of cord. This battledore is kind of coming from the side. See, the umbilical cord is kind of coming from the side. This is the velamentous, where you can see that they are actually, the umbilical cord is attached to the membrane and these blood vessels traverse a distance before they reach the placenta. Right. And here you can see circumvallate placenta. And here you can see placenta suscinturiata, where there is a suscinturiate lobe. Right. And what is the circumvallate placenta? What is the abnormality here? Here they are saying that the fetal membranes fold backwards around the edge of the placenta. So here you can see there is some kind of there's no mixture here. So where is the chorion? So what will happen here? What are you observing here? They are saying this is the chorion. Okay. They have marked it in blue. There is placenta. And there's basically you can see that this type of mixing of the maternal and the fetal thing is not at all happening. So here there will be decreased nutrients to the baby, isn't it? So this circumvallate placenta comes under placenta extracorallis, extracorialis, okay? So in this you have placenta, circumvallate placenta and placenta marginata. But remember guys, battledore placenta is where the cord is attached to the margin, okay? So in this video, what are we trying to look at? We are trying to look at velamentous insertion of cord. So what will you explain about velamentous insertion of cord? Let's come back to the topic. Velamentous insertion of cord, basically, the umbilical cord is attached to the membranes. The fetal vessels are traversing a distance before they are reaching the placenta. In this condition, basically what can happen, it can lead to a condition called as vasa previa. Here you can see that especially if it is a placenta previa, right, and there are vessels like this which are going in the membrane like this, when the baby is trying to come out, these vessels can get compressed or cut, right? What do you say, squeezed. So basically this is a very big problem, that the baby will not get nutrients, isn't it? There is a nutrient cutoff for the baby, so the baby can have a problem. So that is why what they are saying, here is that in front of the presenting part, so this is the fetus, in front of the presenting part, if there is this membrane which is overlying the internal os, then this is condition called as vasa previa, okay? So what will happen when there is a rupture of this membrane, there will be blood vessels inside. This will lead to vaginal bleeding. But this vaginal bleeding is going to be so dangerous. Why? Because the blood is coming from whom? It is the fetal blood, right? The bleeding is entirely fetal blood. So this may lead to fetal exsanguination and even death. What is exsanguination? Basically, it is getting drained of blood, okay? That is what draining is happening. It can get drained of blood. Who? The fetus. Who is suffering in vasa previa? The fetus. The fetus will suffer because the fetus is losing the blood. It's vaginal bleeding. You will think it's the mother, but no, it is actually the fetal blood. How will you manage this? If there is fetal bleeding, you'll have to deliver, urgently you'll have to deliver, okay? If it is this condition, I'm sure if they had predicted it earlier, they wouldn't have even allowed it to go right into a vaginal delivery. They would have thought of a cesarean section. But here they are not saying that you should do cesarean there. Actually, the textbook is saying that you deliver essentially, if there is bleeding, fetal bleeding, you deliver either vaginally or cesarean, but deliver it immediately. That's what they are saying. And then you will estimate the infant's hemoglobin to see that if blood transfusion will be required. Okay. if the baby is dead, then they are doing vaginal delivery. Obviously, they don't want a cesarean section for a dead baby. Now, this is the velamentous insertion of cord. So, you can see here, they have shown inside the membrane how it is. See, the umbilical cord, the vessels are traversing before reaching the placenta. And this is the membrane that gets opened and cut when the cephalic, the presenting part of the baby, the fetus, goes through this and everything gets cut off here, leading to who is suffering? The fetus is suffering. Okay, we'll draw an unhappy fetus here. But I don't like velamentous insertion of cord. I don't like vasa previa. That is what is the baby saying. Okay. Now, this is the velamentous insertion of cord. Actually, where is this? Okay. So, that is what this says. These are examples of velamentous insertion of the umbilical cord. Look at this. Velamentous insertion of the umbilical cord in which major umbilical vessels separate in the fetal membranes before reaching the placental disc. Such a condition is of no major consequence in utero, but could lead to great chance of cord trauma with bleeding during delivery. So during delivery, they are saying there can be problem here. In utero as such, no problem, but during delivery, there can be chance of cord trauma. So that's it, guys. In this video, what did we want to look at? We wanted to look at only and only this condition that is called as the velamentous insertion of the umbilical cord into the placenta. Basically, before reaching the placental disc, the umbilical vessels have to separate in the fetal membranes and etc. I mean, this is not what we want actually. The fetal membranes are separating inside the membranes before reaching the placental disc. That's not what we want, right? So this is velamentous cord insertion. This is important. So you will plan an immediate delivery, especially a cesarean section if you have already planned. But otherwise, they are saying a vaginal delivery also urgently you can do. Check the fetal hemoglobin, blood transfusion you can give for the baby. Okay. That's it, guys. Velamentous insertion of cord over. Bye-bye.